Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 2021 Achievement Awards Recognition Night. We are honored that you have chosen to be with us this evening. My name is Elizabeth Thomas, and I have the privilege of being the Ohio 4-H Foundation Board President. It is my pleasure to be here with you as we recognize many of Ohio's amazing 4-H youth. Tonight, we ask that you use the chat box throughout the evening to post kudos and encouraging messages to all of our award winners. We are also proud of their accomplishments. Tonight, you will be hearing from 30 Achievement Award recipients. But before we get started, I would like to introduce you to this evening's co-MCs, Emmy Beck Aiden and Cecilia Mainzer. Emmy is a 4-H alumna from Athens County and won the Companion Animal Achievement Award in 2017. Cecilia is a 4-H alumna from Medina County, and in 2018, she won the Leadership Achievement Award. Thank you, ladies, for emceeing the program this evening. And now I will turn it over to you, Emmy.
Good evening, and thank you, Elizabeth. I'm Emmy Beck Aiden, and I'm honored to serve as one of your MCs for the evening. We are pleased to have the opportunity to recognize Ohio's most outstanding 4-H members, our sponsors, our donors, and the Ohio 4-H Foundation Board. Through the generosity of our sponsors, many of tonight's outstanding 4-H members will be able to participate in a sponsored 4-H trip that includes once-in-a-lifetime experiences and memories. Thank you so much to our sponsors. And I will now turn it over to Cecilia.
And good evening. I am Cecilia Mainzer, and I'm thrilled to join you this evening. Tonight, our award winners will be sharing with us how their project work in their award area has impacted their life or 4-H career. Now, let's begin recognizing our winners. Again, we encourage you to use the chat features for kudos, shout-outs, and other encouraging messages. Emmy, let's get started with our first set of winners.
Thanks, Cecilia. The first round of awards are the local government awards. The Ohio Township Association sponsors the Ohio Township Association Local Government Awards to encourage and inspire 4-H teens to become responsible citizens who are involved with local government. These awards are presented in recognition of outstanding community service and involvement in local government. This year's Ohio 4-H Local Government Award winners are Elizabeth Fannin and Sam Vessel. Elizabeth Fannin, 17, is an 11-year 4-H member and is active in LAMP projects. Elizabeth is the daughter of Aaron and Ray Ann Fannin from Jackson, Ohio.
Hello, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Fannin, and today I am receiving the Ohio Township Association's Local Government Award. I'm an 11-year 4-H member from Jackson County, Ohio, and I'm a 2020 graduate of Jackson High School. I'm the Vice President of the Jackson County Junior Fair Board. I'm the reigning 2020 Jackson County Fair Queen, and I'm currently the Communications Committee Chair on the Ohio 4-H Teen Leadership Council. Receiving this award is very important to me because I have such a deep passion for government, which is why this fall I am attending The Ohio State University to study agricultural communication. After completing my undergraduate program, I plan to attend law school and then return to my hometown to represent agriculturally based individuals within my community. These individuals have done so much for me, and the least I can do is represent them at a governmental level. Thank you.
Samuel Vessel Jr., 17, is the son of Samuel and Cosetta Vessel of Westchester. He is active in leadership, car teams, communications, and STEM projects.
Hello, I'm Sam Vessel from Butler County. This award is meaningful to me because it highlights all of the work that I've done over my 4-H career to help others and to spread positivity to those around me. My parents raised me to be a responsible citizen, and in that regard, I feel an obligation to my family, neighbors, and my community to do all that I can to aid others. It's very encouraging to receive this award and know that people recognize what I'm doing, and it gives me extra motivation to continue forward. I believe as a future engineer, I will have the ability and interpersonal skills learned in 4-H to change the world for the better. I plan to keep finding new ways to be a servant leader. And today I'm extremely grateful to receive this award, and I want to thank you for honoring me.
We would now like to take the opportunity to introduce our National 4-H Dairy Conference Award recipients. COBA Select Sires Incorporated sponsors Ohio's delegates to the National 4-H Dairy Conference this fall in Madison, Wisconsin. The 2021 Ohio delegates are Madeline Thayer and Erica Zider. Madeline Thayer, 16, has been in 4-H for 10 years and is the daughter of Matt and Don Thayer from Erie County, Ohio. She's active in livestock and still projects and runs her own business selling mums.
Hi, I'm Madeline Thayer. I'm 15 years old and I'm from Erie County. This award is extremely important to me because my family history is dairy. Both two sets of my great-grandparents were dairy farmers. My grandpa, Dennis Stacy, won the National Dairy Judging through FFA in 1967. My parents built a dairy farm from the ground up starting in 2003. And I have taken a multitude of dairy projects to the Erie County Fair, from dairy heifers to dairy beef feeders and dairy steers. So dairy is just a part of me. Thank you.
Erica Zider is the daughter of Brad and Carla Zider of Fulton County. As a homeschooling high school junior, she is an active 9-year member of Goats and Other Things 4-H Club and is president of the Fulton County Junior Fair Board. She's the 2021 Ohio Dairy Goat Association Youth Ambassador. As an avid showman, Erica has won many showmanship and breed classes with her dairy goats. She dreams of being a dairy goat judge someday.
Each year, two outstanding 4-H members are selected to represent Ohio 4-H for a 2-year term on the State Junior Fair Board. The State Junior Fair Board is sponsored by the Ohio Expo Center and State Fair. This year's selections are Elizabeth Fannin and Sarah Newsom. Elizabeth Fannin, 17, is an 11-year 4-H member and is active in lamb projects. Elizabeth is the daughter of Aaron and Ryan Fannin from Jackson, Ohio. Sarah Newsom, 17, is the daughter of Terry and Tammy Newsom from Hillsboro, Ohio. An 8-year 4-H member in Highland County, she is active in poultry, leadership, SES, and engineering projects. Sarah strives to help younger members achieve their goals and grow into valuable life skills. The final award portion of the evening is our Achievement Award winner recipients. This November, 4-H youth from across the country will arrive in Atlanta, Georgia for National 4-H Congress. Since 1922, National 4-H Congress has been the event in which the most outstanding 4-H members from each state are recognized and involved in once-in-a-lifetime leadership, citizenship, and community service experiences. Ohio's 4-H Congress trip winners are selected based on accomplishments reported in their Ohio 4-H achievement records. This year, we had 293 Ohio 4-H achievement records that were considered at the state level for this award. It gives us great pleasure to introduce to you Ohio's 2021 National 4-H Congress delegates and their sponsors. Our first state achievement award is the Beef Achievement Award that is being sponsored by Ohio Cattlewomen's Association and Donna Tullis. This year's recipient is Abigail Toole. Abby Toole, 18, is an 11-year 4-H member who has been active in many livestock projects. Abby is the daughter of Amy and Charles Toole and lives in Amanda, Ohio, located in Fairfield County.
My name is Abby Toole, and I'm so thankful to be this year's Beef Achievement Award winner. By showing beef projects, I've learned many life lessons and I've had numerous opportunities, which I am so thankful for. I have learned to smile through the most difficult times, the responsibility that it takes to handle one of these guys, as well as the hard work and dedication that it takes into showing one. By showing beef, I'm really glad that I had these opportunities because as a future veterinarian, I've learned basic handling skills that I will take with me through my future career. But I've also had the opportunity to start my own 4-H or my own cattle herd through 4-H, which has been super nice because even though I am wrapping up my showing career, I can continue this legacy and this passion that I found through 4-H as I continue to have calves, such as this little girl from past show heifers.
Julia Hartline is this year's Carteens Award winner. The Carteens Achievement Award is sponsored by the State Farm Insurance Foundation. Julia Hartline, 16, is an 11-year member of 4-H and has been an active member in CAR Teens for 3 years. Julia has also completed projects in dairy breeding, market goat, and leadership projects. Julia is the daughter of Jeff and Catherine Hartline of Marietta, Ohio, located in Washington County.
Hi, I'm Julia Hartline. I've been a part of 4-H for 12 years, and I'm currently a part of the Backyard Gang 4-H Club and the Washington County CAR Teens 4-H Club. I'm 16 years old, and I attend the Washington County Career Center for the Medical College Prep Program. The project I took was about CAR Teens, which is a club I'm in, and in this club, we teens teach other teens about safe driving. So these teens have got maybe a ticket or gotten a wreck, and they have to come to this program. And we have a trooper talk, we have videos, we play games. It's a really fun time, but you're also learning about safe driving. We have learned that teens listen to other teens better than they would adults, so that's why teens teach CAR Teens. This club isn't only great for the kids who are participating, but also for the teens that are leading it, because we learn about safe driving while teaching others about safe driving. So I also take a lot of STILL projects like nutrition and clothing, and I've also taken market goats and dairy cows to the fair. And throughout all these projects and through 4-H, I've learned leadership, hard work, communication, and great public speaking skills. I'd like to thank my parents, my 4-H educators, my brother, and my 4-H advisors for helping me become the great 4-H leader I am today. Thank you.
Dalton Henry is our Citizenship and Community Service Achievement Award winner. The Citizenship and Community Service Award category is sponsored by Provost Bruce McFerrin and his wife, Marilyn. Dalton Henry, 18, is son of Jill Henry and the late John Henry. He has been a 4-H member for 9 years and is active in the Fairfield County Green Extreme 4-H Club.
9 years of 4-H has shown me the importance of being a good citizen and giving back to my community. When I completed 4-H projects in areas such as mechanical engineering and science, woodworking, food and nutrition, health and safety, and leadership, community service was all a big part of the project area. Participation not only in my 4-H club, but also a camp counselor, junior fair board member, Fairfield County advisory and endowment board member, and a state 4-H health hero have all also taught me the importance of community service. Activities such as promoting 4-H, teaching health classes in the local middle school, making centerpieces for the endowment banquet, working my club's annual community day, working in my local food pantry, cooking food for the Ronald McDonald House, making dog toys for the local dog shelter, or even helping with the youth at church events or even running the soundboard at church, has taught me the rewards of community service. I've learned that even the smallest action can make a big difference to someone. 4-H has been a program that has given me lots of special memories and friendships, but has also shaped who I am today. I will always be thankful for 4-H. Thank you.
The Clothing and Textiles Achievement Award recipient is Eliza Jane Morrow. The sponsor of this award is the Huffman family. Eliza Jane Morrow, 15, is the daughter of David and Lori Morrow. She has been a Muskingum County 4-H member for 9 years and is active in sewing and textile, beef, and swine projects.
My award area has impacted my life in so many different ways. I started sewing when I was 3 years old with my grandma, and the first thing I made was a little pink shirt that I wore everywhere. From that day, I knew that I loved sewing. So I kept doing it. And as the years progressed, I've gotten better. My first year in 4-H, I set the bar really high for myself for the next years. I won Outstanding of the Day at the Ohio State Fair my first year in 4-H with my sundresses and jumpers project. And I was so surprised and honestly shocked because it was my first year in 4-H. Sewing has affected my day-to-day life by, for example, I love musical theater, and it has allowed me to make costumes for other cast members and repair costumes for myself and other cast members. Or I got to make a Greek toga for my 7th grade social studies project for Greece. Other things that it's allowed me to do is community service. Like, I made masks for the Ohio State University staff that allowed hearing impaired students to be able to lip read, because there was vinyl around vinyl part of the mask so that you could see the mouth moving.
The Communications Achievement Award winner is Sam Vessel. The sponsor of this award is Carolyn Esselgroth. Samuel Vessel Jr. is a 13-year Butler County 4-H member dedicated to leadership and communications projects. Samuel is the son of Samuel and Cosetta Vessel of Westchester, Ohio.
I'm Sam Vessel from Butler County. I want to briefly share how my 4-H public speaking opportunities have helped me grow. Through 4-H, I've learned how to give a speech, how to be calm and relaxed in front of an audience, and how to speak confidently with strangers. In fact, my first job interview was successful due to the many years of practice with judging for my various 4-H projects. It has not always been easy, and it's taken me years to become comfortable with my voice, especially on stage. However, through the confidence I've found in 4-H and with the encouragement of others, I've been able to utilize my communication skills to achieve great things and to keep opening new doors by stepping outside of my comfort zone. My 13 years of 4-H have been full of well-rounded personal development. With 1 year left, I hope to leave a lasting legacy for younger members and to continue using my voice now and in the future to make positive change. Thank you.
The Companion Animals Achievement Award winner is Allie Carter. The sponsor of this award is the Nationwide Foundation. Allie Carter, age 17, is the daughter of Joe and Shannon Carter of Fairfield County. She's a 9-year 4-H member who enjoys showing guinea pigs, rabbits, and quilts.
Hi, my name is Allie Carter, and I'm from Fairfield County. I've been companion animals for as long as I've been in 4-H, about 9 years. I've taken tabbies each year and recently added pet rabbits. I remember that my first guinea pig was more than a project. She was my pet and my friend. That's why it was so fun to take her as a project. No matter what happened, I learned something each year and I had a friend with me along the way. Since then, I've greatly expanded my knowledge and experience and branched out to rabbits. 4-H has helped me to become closer to my animals and taught me to take better care of them. Every chance I get, I promote 4-H, the Tabby Project, and companion animals. My work in tabbies has opened up other opportunities as well. Last year, as senior tabby showman, I got to participate in my county fair Small Animal Showman of Showman contest and won. I'm honored to be this year's achievement winner for companion animals, and I can't wait to go to 4-H Congress this fall. I'm excited to meet other outstanding 4-Hers from all over the nation.
The Creative Arts Achievement Award winner is Meredith Robinson. The sponsors of this award are Ron and Carolyn Cole. Meredith Robinson, 17, is an 11-year Ross County 4-H member active in Market Go projects and many miscellaneous projects. She has had numerous amazing experiences throughout her career and is proud to continue in 4-H. Meredith is the daughter of Jason and Katrina Robinson.
Hi, my name is Meredith Robinson, and I am an 11-year 4-H member from Ross County, Ohio. It is an honor to have been selected as the 2021 Ohio Achievement Award winner in the Creative Arts Division. This award means a great deal to me. It is amazing to be recognized for all the hard work and love I have poured into my projects over these past 8 years. Not only have I had a lot of fun completing the projects, but I have also been able to grow closer to my family and our history. My two favorite projects have been the scrapbooks I've made about my paternal grandparents. The Creative Arts Division has allowed me to explore new areas and become more involved in 4-H outside of my livestock projects. I look forward to attending National 4-H Congress this fall and enjoying my last year of 4-H in 2022. Thank you.
The Dairy Achievement Award recipient is Sarah Schmeckel. ST Genetics, the Ohio Heifer Center, is the sponsor of this award. Sarah Schmeckel, 16, is in her 8th year of 4-H and is active in dairy, pygmy goat, and rabbit projects. Sarah is the daughter of Steve and Melanie Schmeckel of Johnson, Ohio, located in Licking County.
Hi, my name is Sarah Schmeckel, and this is my 8th year showing at the Hartford Fair. I recently turned 16 years old, and I am a sophomore attending Johnstown Monroe High School. 4-H has taught me in many different ways that I didn't expect. Before entering 4-H, I was a shy young girl with no confidence in myself or my animal. 8 years later, I can look back and see how far I've come. From running away minutes before my first show to now being proud while entering the ring and very excited. Winning this award is another step in building character, and I'm very grateful for all the opportunities God's provided. It shows all the blood, sweat, and tears that I've poured into my projects over the years. 4-H comes with its ups and downs, but it prepares you for any upcoming battles. 4-H isn't just a hobby, it's life-changing by meeting new people and getting out of my comfort zone. Thank you.
This year's Environmental Sciences Achievement Award recipient is Braden Monahan. The Environmental Sciences Achievement Award sponsor is Derek and Angela Dustheimer. Braden Monahan, 19, is a 10-year 4-H member in Roman Country Raisers in Fulton County. He has been active in beekeeping and other environmental projects. Braden is the son of Kevin and Nicole Monahan.
Hi, my name is Braden Monahan, and I have received the 4-H Achievement Award for Environmental Sciences. I feel as if my project work in environmental sciences has come with a positive impact on my everyday life. With all the information I have learned with my 4-H projects, such as beekeeping, animal projects, and an assortment of environmentally based self-determined projects, has allowed me to apply and develop skills in my interactions with the environment daily. The love of environmental sciences has pushed me to pursue a future in environmental engineering that I'm currently practicing. I feel as if my project work has allowed me to share my skills with my peers and my 4-H club members. This award means a lot to me because it has proved to me that 4-H wasn't just a club. 4-H has accepted my love and passion for the environment and has shown me that I can apply this love well into my future.
This year's Family Life and Child Development Achievement Award recipient is Cassidy Lange. The Family Life and Child Development Achievement Award sponsor is Ken and Krista Davis. Cassidy Lange, 16, is an 11-year 4-H member active in a goat, chicken, duck, and health projects. Cassidy is the daughter of Susan and Daryl Lange and lives in Commercial Point, Ohio, located in Pickaway County.
Good evening. My name is Cassidy Lange. I am the 16-year-old daughter of Susan and Daryl Lange. I am a 4-H member in Pickaway County. I have been in 4-H since I was in kindergarten, so this is my 11th year in 4-H. The project work I have done in 4-H has helped me to become a better leader in my community and at school. It has also taught me to be responsible and to work hard at everything that I do. I have learned time management and, most importantly, that hard work and dedication do pay off. This achievement award is meaningful to me because I am the youngest of three girls and both of my older sisters also won the 4-H Achievement Award. It is also nice to be recognized and rewarded for my hard work and sacrifices I have made to succeed in 4-H.
The Food and Nutrition Achievement Award winner is Abigail Brees. This award is sponsored by Dr. Greg and Debbie West. Abigail Brees, 16, is the daughter of Brad and Laura Brees from Hancock County. She is a 9-year member of the His Kids 4-H Club. That's fun to say. Abigail takes a large variety of miscellaneous projects and also shows cattle at the county fair.
Hi, I'm Abby Brees from Hancock County, and I'm this year's Food and Nutrition Project State Achievement Award winner. So after 9 years I've been involved in 4-H, I have taken a food project each year. I started off with just making snacks for fun, but am now creating home meals for my family. I have not only learned how to cook, but I've also learned how to make healthier meals and healthier options in these projects as well. The projects teach you how to substitute ingredients and compare nutritional facts to find the best options in the foods. Another thing I do in the projects is learn how to shop cheaper for food products. They teach you how to go to the stores and compare the different prices and look for the cheapest options. This will all benefit me in the future as I go off to college and eventually move out because I already know how to cook for myself as well as save money too.
The Gardening and Horticulture Award winner is Shannon Barr. The Gardening and Horticulture Achievement Award is sponsored by Howard and Cynthia Wingert. Shannon Barr, 15, has completed 7 years of 4-H gardening projects. She's the daughter of Dan and Amy Barr from Delaware County. Shannon enjoys taking care of her own garden and volunteering her time for the Wexner Medical Center's Garden of Hope.
I'm so honored to win the State Achievement Award for gardening this year. It's so nice to have the experience growing my own food and flowers. and taking 4-H projects over the years has helped me appreciate nature and understand a variety of plants and how to nurture them. 4-H has given me the opportunity to try new vegetables and herbs while I'm cooking, and I'm excited to take the Edible Landscapes project this year along with my vegetables project. 4-H has also given me volunteer opportunities to help people like the cancer patients at the Garden of Hope. And I'm really looking forward to going to the National 4-H Congress this year and seeing my fellow 4-H award winners.
Our next award is the GOATS Achievement Award, and this year's winner is Erica Zider. This award is sponsored by Howard and Judy Warner. Erica Zider is the daughter of Brad and Carla Zider of Fulton County. As a homeschooling high school junior, she is an active 9-year member of GOATS and Other Things 4-H Club and is president of the Fulton County Junior Fair Board. She's the 2021 Ohio Dairy Goat Association Youth Ambassador. As an avid showman, Erica has won many showmanship and breed classes with her dairy goats, and she dreams of being a dairy goat judge someday.
Our next award is the Health and Safety Achievement Award, and our winner is Aiden Mowry. This award is sponsored by the Ohio Electric Cooperative. Aiden Mowry is the son of Lance and Dr. Mary Beth Kennedy Mowry from Hancock County. In his 8 years of 4-H, Aiden has been a camp counselor, a junior fair board member, and is on the state fashion board.
Hello, my name is Aiden Mowry, and I am in my 9th year of 4-H and live in Hancock County. The achievement award I will be receiving is for health and safety. It is an amazing honor to have been chosen for this. I plan to pursue a career in health science in the future. I will be obtaining my Associate of Science degree from Terre State Community College in May 2022, several weeks before I graduate from Van Buren High School. I have focused on mainly health and science projects through my 4-H career, but I have also taken food and nutrition, clothing, money, and many other projects. At the state level, I'm involved in State Fashion Board for 2 years, and in my county, I'm involved in Hancock Youth Leadership for 1 year, and I'm also in Junior Fair Board and a camp counselor for the past 3 years. I love being able to learn about health and other sciences and felt privileged to receive several clock trophies and outstanding of the days at the Ohio State Fair. I'm the youngest member in my family with 4 siblings, 3 older sisters and 1 older brother, who have all won 4-H Achievement Awards. Actually, 2 of them have also won them in health and safety. I'd like to thank my sponsors for giving me this opportunity to attend 4-H Congress. I know it'll be an experience of a lifetime.
Our next award, the Horse Achievement Award, goes to Madison Johnson. This award is sponsored by Schneider Saddlery. Madison Johnson, 17, has been a 4-H member for 9 years and is active in horse and beef feeder projects. Madison is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Heath Johnson from Fayette County.
Hi, I'm Madison Johnson, and my 4-H Achievement Award project is a horse. Showing horses has tremendously impacted my life and 4-H career. I began showing at open shows when I was 5 years old. By the time I was 9, there was nothing I loved more than 4-H shows, and after lots of hard work and dedication, I was able to begin showing on a larger scale at AQHA shows. Throughout the years, there have been many early mornings and late nights, either out at a show or out at the barn, but there's no other way. I would have rather learned the importance of responsibility, independence, determination, and gratitude. Obtaining these traits and learning to use them at such a young age has continuously helped me reach my goals, whether they be personal, academic, or 4-H related. Without 4-H, I would not be the person I am today, and I will always be thankful for the impact of the lessons and experiences that I have gained through 4-H.
We have 2 winners in the area of leadership in no particular order. The first winner of the State 4-H Leadership Achievement Award is Sarah Newsom, and her award has been sponsored by Clarence and Jane Cunningham. Sarah Newsom, 17, is the daughter of Terry and Tammy Newsom from Hillsboro, Ohio. An 8-year 4-H member in Highland County, she is active in poultry, leadership, FCS, and engineering projects. Sarah strives to help younger members achieve their goals and grow into valuable life skills.
Throughout my years in 4-H, one of my favorite project areas has been leadership, because not only does it allow you to dive into your own personal development and to grow in so many essential skill areas, but it really does encourage you to facilitate that growth within others. And something I've really taken a look back on recently as I've looked at this award and filled out my achievement records is the ability that I've had to encourage the youth coming after me, that next generation of 4-Hers, to pursue those same skills and talents that I have gotten to foster over the past few years. I can truly say that with this award, I really do hope to continue to advocate for leadership projects, continue to encourage youth to grow not only in their own personal leadership skills and those skills, like I said, that they will take with them throughout their lives, but also to continue that legacy of bringing them into the next generation. Youth truly are the future of our nation, and we owe it to them to continue to provide those opportunities for them to grow and to prosper in their own ways.
The second Leadership Award winner is Hannah Henry. This second award is sponsored by Bill Patterson. Hannah Henry, 18, is the daughter of Jill Henry and the late John Henry. She has been a 4-H member for 10 years and is active in the Fairfield County Green Extreme 4-H Club.
4-H has provided me with endless amounts of leadership opportunities so that I could make unforgettable memories as well as grow into the woman I am today. During my first year in 4-H, I was absolutely terrified to do a demonstration in front of my club. I decided to do a demonstration on how to make pom-poms for flip-flops out of yarn. I worked extremely hard preparing for my demonstration just to completely mess it up in front of my club members. Now, I am proudly serving as the Fairfield County Fair Queen and traveling all across Ohio promoting my county fair. I have taken projects in sewing, cooking, health and safety, and leadership so that I could become a well-rounded 4-H'er. I'm extremely excited to be receiving the Ohio 4-H Achievement Award for Leadership because it validates all the hard work I have put into my 4-H career. I'm extremely grateful for the memories I have made in the past 10 years, and I'm excited to be able to use the qualities I have learned about leadership in my future.
The Mechanical and Engineering Science Achievement Award winner is Kayler Bird. The award is sponsored by the Packer family. Kayler Bird, 18, is a 9-year 4-H member, active primarily in STEM projects. Kayler is the son of Neilston and Christina Bird of Fairfield County.
Hi, my name is Kayler Bird. I've been in 4-H for 10 years. I've done many projects over the years, but my favorite has been rockets, electricity, and knots. I wanted to say for in all those, but I had a state collect trophy for knots when I built a hammock. That's led me to having a future career either going in the Army for fiber optics or going to Columbus State for electrical mechanical engineering. This award is meaningful to me because it shows that doing 4-H has not been in vain in learning all that information. Using my experience with this, it's led me to like showing a positive difference that I can do. And thank you for all who made this possible over the past 10 years, all my leaders, family, and all the volunteers that judged at State Fair and county level. Thank you.
We had two Personal Development Award winners. In no particular order, the first Personal Development Achievement Award winner is Elizabeth Fannin, sponsored by Dr. Kathryn Kress, Dean of the College of Food, Agricultural, and Environmental Sciences. Elizabeth Fannin, 17, is an 11-year 4-H member and is active in LAMB projects. Elizabeth is the daughter of Aaron and Ray Ann Fannin from Jackson County.
Hello, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Fannin, and today I'm receiving the Personal Development Achievement Award. I'm an 11-year 4-H member from Jackson County, Ohio, and I'm a 2021 graduate of Jackson High School. I currently serve as the Vice President of the Jackson County Junior Fair Board. I'm the reigning 2020 Jackson County Fair Queen, and I'm the Communications Committee Chair on the Ohio 4-H Teen Leadership Council. I've shown various livestock projects throughout my time in 4-H, and if I'm not in the barn, you can probably catch me visiting elementary schools to promote 4-H within my county, or jumping from fairs to festivals with my royalty court. Whether I have a crown on my head or boots on my feet, 4-H is always pushing me outside of my comfort zone and breaking me out of my shell. The best analogy I can think of is the High Ropes Corps at Cannage Cave 4-H Camp. Although I was really scared to go up at first, my fellow counselors encouraged me, and I was still really scared when I got in the air. But once I was up there, I became confident within what I was doing, and I see the same thing in every experience I've had within 4-H. Although my personal development varies from year to year and varies between project areas, one thing stays consistent, and that is my growth. Thank you.
Gretchen Search is this year's second Personal Development Award winner, sponsored by Jim and Marlene Helt. Gretchen Search, 17, is the daughter of Susan and Bill Search. She's a 12-year Ross County 4-H member and has taken at least one project from every category. Gretchen is a camp counselor and a member of the Ohio 4-H Team Leadership Council.
Hello, my name is Gretchen Search, and I am an Ohio 4-H Award recipient for the Personal Development Achievement Award. I am a 13-year member in Ross County 4-H, and I have taken many projects over this time that have contributed to my personal development. All of the projects I have taken have given me new knowledge and life skills that have been useful over the course of my 4-H career and will continue to be throughout the rest of my career and life. Because of 4-H, I am a better public speaker, I can sew, I know how to care for chickens, for bees, I also know how to use graphic design, how to use knots and their different purposes, and I also know the basics of woodworking, among other skills that I have developed over the course of my 4-H career. I am very thankful to have received this award. It is a very high honor that I do not take lightly, and it is something I have worked for my entire 4-H career. Thank you for your time.
Anna Holshue is the winner of the Photography Achievement Award, sponsored by Jed Osborne. Anna Holshue, 15, is the daughter of Bill and Pam Holshue and lives in Marietta, Ohio, located in Washington County. She has been a 4-H member for 6 years and is active in photography projects.
Hi, my name is Anna Holshue. I have been awarded the Photography Achievement Award. I have done all four photography 4-H projects, and here is one of my pictures from Photography Master. The four projects have taught me many things, not just in 4-H, but for my personal life too. It has taught me to have better time management skills, better organization, and to follow things through. At first, I wasn't very sure about the photography projects. I didn't know if I was going to like them, if I wanted to finish them, but I'm very glad that I did. At the beginning, I was not very good at turning things in on time or being very organized, but after finishing them, I have had so much better time management and organization, not just for 4-H, but for school too. I'm very glad that I got to finish the projects. I am very fortunate to have this award. Thank you.
The Poultry Achievement Award winner is Bridget Donnelly. This award is sponsored by the Nationwide Foundation. Bridget Donnelly, 18, is the daughter of Edward and Dana Donnelly of Mahoning County. She's an active 4-H member in predominantly the llama and poultry projects. Bridget had started her own business supplying poultry products to restaurants and aspires to be an avian vet.
Hello, I'm delighted to be named a 2021 Ohio 4-H Achievement Award recipient for poultry. It was through the Ohio 4-H Poultry Project my dedication to all things avian really took off. It began with simple enough research about different breeds I was interested in, but has advanced into a full-on passion for genetics, especially Rare Breed Conservancy. An unexpected joy from my involvement with poultry has been the opportunity to share my excitement, enthusiasm, and knowledge with younger 4-H poultry members. Not only in my home county, but throughout the state. I take an immense amount of pride in my kids' accomplishments, both in and out of the show ring, and always look for new ways to make the best better, as we say. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I'm unbelievably grateful and truly honored to be given the chance to represent Ohio in any form at the National 4-H Congress. More importantly, I hope this award will allow me to teach more people about my passion and maybe even find their own.
The Rabbits Achievement Award winner is Shelby Jones. The Rabbits Award category is sponsored by Dr. Elizabeth and Nelson Thomas. Shelby Jones, 17, is the daughter of Byron and Rachel Jones of Milford Center, Ohio. She is a senior in high school and a 10-year Union County 4-H member and focuses on rabbit and duck projects.
Hi, my name is Shelby Jones, and this is Nova and Emerald, two of my homegrown rabbits. Without 4-H, I wouldn't be where I am today. Raising rabbits and livestock at all has taught me how to work hard, have patience and dedication towards a hobby, as well as how to get my hands a little dirty. Raising rabbits from start to finish is difficult but very rewarding. Rabbits start as hairless, helpless creatures that can eventually grow into a show quality animal like Emerald here, who has won a best of breed. Over the years, I've loved learning about rabbits and enhancing my knowledge of them. Some things I've had the most fun learning are how to assess rabbits for show potential, the color genetics, and how to make proper breeding pairs based on their color varieties. I've also learned lots of basic animal care and husbandry. In my future career as a veterinarian, all of this knowledge will come to great use, especially if I decide to go the route of small animals and rabbits. This award means so much to me, as it's helped to bring my 10 years of 4-H and raising rabbits to a close.
This year's Sheep Achievement Award recipient is Adeline Kendall. The Sheep Achievement Award is sponsored by Tom and Mary Harp. Adeline Kendall, 16, is an 11-year 4-H member and is involved in livestock and miscellaneous projects. Adeline is the daughter of Todd and Christine Kendall of New Philadelphia, located in Tuscarawas County.
Hi, I'm Addie Kendall, the 2021 Sheep Achievement Award winner. I'm a 10-year 4-H member from Tuscarawas County, Ohio. I love taking the sheep project and showing my sheep. Through the project, I have learned responsibility, dedication, hard work, and leadership skills. I spend many hours in the barn every day working to get my sheep ready for shows. This will help me to prepare for future jobs and leadership roles I will fulfill. I now mentor younger members to help them get ready for shows and to become great showmen. I also help them to learn the daily care and responsibility of taking care of their animals. Through the project, I have made many, many friends throughout the state and nation that will last a lifetime.
The Shooting Sports Achievement Award winner is Jonathan Dorston. This award is sponsored by the Ohio 4-H Shooting Sports Program. Jonathan Dorston, 17, is an 11-year 4-H member active in shooting sports. Jonathan is the son of Damian and Carolyn Dorston from Bryan in Williams County.
My name is Jonathan Dorston. I've been taking shooting sports for around 12 years. I have loved every bit of it. I started with archery and have transitioned into pistol. I first started competitive shooting through the 4-H Club with the Scholastic Action Shooting Program. From there, I was asked to shoot air pistol for the 4-H Nationals in 2018. I loved air pistol and have continued ever since. I kept practicing and attended local competitions. This eventually led me to compete in Junior Olympic Championships, as well as to compete for Team USA in the El Salvador Junior Grand Prix. This June, I'll be competing to remake the Junior National Team. As well as shooting sports, my projects have helped me in leadership skills and other life lessons. With leadership, I have been able to become better at leading meetings, as I am the club president, and has helped me with being a camp counselor. Outside of 4-H, my leadership has helped me on the soccer field and other sports that I participate in.
This year's swine winner is Emma Leggett. Irv and Jean Bell sponsored this award. Emma Leggett, 17, has been a 4-H member for the past 8 years and is active in swine projects. Emma is the daughter of Holly and Derek Leggett from Tuscarawas County.
Hi, my name is Emma Leggett. I am a senior at Claymont High School. I have been involved in 4-H for the past 8 years and have shown swine the past 7 through the Tuscarawas County Fair and then the Ohio State Fair and through the 0-H Show Pig Summer Circuit. My involvement in 4-H has impacted me in many different ways by helping me develop my character, but most importantly by helping me decide what I want to do for the remainder of my career. I hope to go to the Ohio State University Worcester campus to major in animal science with a specialization in beef and swine nutrition and a minor in agribusiness. With that major and minor, I want to help farmers with their feeding plans so their animals have a very healthy harvest and so their consumers are consuming healthy products. I also hope to become a swine judge throughout the U.S., judging local county shows and jackpot shows and helping show that women in this industry can do everything that I hope to become.
The Veterinary Science Achievement Award winner is Chloe Creakey. Steve and Cindy Rasmussen have sponsored this award. Chloe Creakey, 17, is a 9-year member of the Lions Lucky Leaders 4-H Club in Fulton County. She is an active member of the Toledo Zoo Teen Program.
Hello, I am Chloe Creakey, this year's recipient of the Veterinarian Science Ohio 4-H Achievement Award. First, I would like to thank the committee and sponsors for the support of Ohio 4-H. Since I was old enough to walk, I have been fascinated with animals, so it's no surprise that most of my life revolves around 4-H and animals, and why I hope to pursue a career in animal science. Through 4-H, I have taken several vet science projects, as well as a market rabbit, market lambs, and market hogs. Through each of these projects, I have had the opportunity to expand my knowledge and skills when it comes to the care of animals. Because of my experiences in 4-H, I have had the chance to volunteer at local humane societies and through the Toledo Zoo Team program. I have been able to participate in field research, job shadow in a vet clinic, and educate public on zoo animals. With these 4-H experiences, I was accepted to attend the Junior Broiler Vet Camp at Purdue University in 2017 and an Ag Discovery Camp at the University of Hawaii at Manoa in 2018. Next summer, I will be attending a vet science camp in Sydney, Australia. I am so grateful to have been selected for this award and appreciate the recognition of my time and experiences in Ohio 4-H.
The Woodworking Achievement Award winner is Hunter Snell. Sponsored by the Honorable Fred Pepple and his wife Kathy Pepple. Hunter Snell, 16, is a 10-year 4-H member active in woodworking, engineering, and rabbit projects. His woodworking gives him a sense of pride and accomplishment, especially when they're gifts. Hunter is the son of Karen and Mike Thompson from Noble County.
Hi, my name is Hunter Snell. I am honored to receive the Ohio 4-H Woodworking Achievement Award because woodworking has helped me grow into a more confident and creative person. The dedication and hard work it takes to make quality wood projects has expanded my dedication to 4-H by giving me the confidence to be an active member of the Teen Ambassadors and Junior Fair Board. The attention to detail required in woodworking and the skills needed to communicate well during judging has helped to better prepare me to be the best president I can be for my 4-H club, as well as a role model to my fellow 4-H members. I am proud of all of my woodworking projects, especially ones I have made as special gifts. Thanks to my woodworking experiences in 4-H, I am setting my sights on a hands-on career as a plumber and pipe fitter while planning to enjoy woodworking as a lifelong hobby. This award helps prove to myself that I have the ability to accomplish great things. Thank you.
Please join me in congratulating these youth on their accomplishments. We would also like to recognize and thank those who have made these trips possible for these youth through sponsorship. It is through the generous giving of our supporters that these kinds of experiences can take place. Sponsors are how it all happens. We are so grateful. At this time, I would like to turn it over to Bonnie Ayers, Dairy Program Specialist, for special recognition.
Thank you, Lion King, for the lyrics that remind us of the cycle of life. It is a story of beginnings and endings and what puts us into perpetual motion. Even a pandemic cannot halt this process. Just as you have heard these young and aspiring 4-H'ers create their visions, it is only a beginning to what they could possibly achieve. However, tonight, we cannot fail to look back in retrospect to the career and life of our very own Dr. Lucinda Miller with 4-H, since she has now recently retired. She leaves a legacy of steadfast dedication, extreme loyalty, and a lifetime of commitment to the 4-H pledge. Many of you will recall her work with companion and small animal programs and their surge in growth. If you attend the state fair, she was the recognizable face behind skillathons and the go-to person on policy and rules. Quality assurance was also deep within her soul, and beyond that, her leadership was integral for statewide extension programs with human-animal interaction and veterinary science projects. Wow. Her character encouraged and stimulated teamwork in a setting that was nationally and internationally recognized, but most respected among her peers. Lucinda was constantly updating her academic portfolio to reflect what needed to be taught and shared with us as appropriate subject matter with people and animals. All the while, she was coaching youth to follow in her footsteps of professional dedication. The wealth of publications, curriculum development, financial resource, and yes, even quiz bowl trivia is a part of all of us and all of you. And we recognize it to Lucinda's backstage performances of life. Lest we forget, remember that all this took place as her own family was growing and developing in the 4-H way. So to Lucinda, my peer, my colleague, but most of all, my friend, tonight is your Academy Award that was not just a role created, but a genuine desire to make the best better. Congratulations on every beginning and ending that is now scripted in your life as you bicycle down a new path of growth and development. But Lucinda, keep that helmet on tightly, because the path is winding and full of surprises. Thank you, Lucinda. Thank you for being a part of all of us and the legacy you leave.
Thanks, Bonnie. I have had the benefit of all of the work that Lucinda has tirelessly put into the Small and Companion Animals program. Congratulations to Lucinda. She'll be very missed. At this time, I would now like to introduce Dr. Kirk Bloor, State 4-H leader, for some closing remarks.
It's been a privilege and pleasure to watch this evening's program unfold, hearing from our outstanding youth and celebrating their accomplishments. This evening's youth honorees have had an incredible journey through the Ohio 4-H program. Each of them is a shining example of the true leaders that we continue to grow through Ohio 4-H. And I also want to recognize the parents, advisors, and other leaders who have supported and nurtured our teens throughout their 4-H journey. Thank you for the commitments you make to help 4-H youth find their sparks, develop their knowledge and skills, and grow into caring, capable, competent, contributing citizens, the next generation of true leaders. Before signing off, I want to thank Cecilia and Emmy for serving as our MCs and to extend a hearty thank you to all of our sponsors, board members, State 4-H and Foundation staff and guests. Your ongoing and generous support helps make the Ohio 4-H Achievement Awards possible. Congratulations once again to all of our 2021 Ohio 4-H Award winners. Your commitment to making the best better is certainly evident. There's no doubting that our future is in very capable hands. Thank you all for joining us this evening for our awards recognition event. This concludes our virtual celebration. Stay healthy and have a good night.